Good morning. Now we're going to look at chapter 3, which is synchronous motors. Now, if we look at our single line diagram, we can see that the current is now flowing towards the motor, and therefore E is equal to V minus I motor ZS. Now, let's look at the phasor diagram. Let's consider a lagging power factor. Remember, for an alternator, lagging current was downwards as IA. Now, IM is minus IA, therefore, it will be in the opposite direction. So, if we start by drawing a phasor diagram, V is our reference voltage, then IMRA is always in phase with the current causing it. And then IMXS is leading the current that is causing it. So therefore, we can look at the figure and then we can see that E is the sum of those voltage drops. Yeah, E is less than V. And delta is negative. Now, if you look at the lagging power factor, you can see that IM is now downwards. And therefore, if we have IZ, it should be IR, IMR, and IXS. Drawn as shown. In this case, E is bigger than V. Now let's look at an example. Twenty pole, 693 volt, 50 hertz, 3-phase delta connected synchronous motor operates at no load with excitation to give 693 on open circuit. The impedance is 0 plus J10 ohms per phase. And if the rotor is retarded by 0.5 degrees mechanical, from the synchronous position, we have to calculate the rotor displacement in electrical degrees, and then the induced EMF, the current per phase, power drawn by the motor, developed power by the armature, and the change in these quantities when the motor is loaded, so that the rotor displacement becomes 5 degrees mechanical. So delta is P times mechanical degrees. It's a 20 pole machine, so pole pairs times 0.5 gives us 5 electrical degrees. And there, E is equal to V at no load, because, and the voltage is 693. So IX is V angle 0 minus E angle minus delta. So that's 693 angle 0 minus 693 angle minus 5, which gives us 60.457 at an angle of 87.5 degrees. Therefore, the current will be 60.457 at an angle of 87.5 divided by 10 angle 90, which gives us a current of 6.05 at an angle of minus 2.5. The input is V phase, I phase, cos phi, which gives us 4188.66 watts per phase. Total is 12.566 kilowatt. And since R is negligible, the developed power is equal to the input power. Now B, if delta is now 5 degrees mechanical, that means it will be 50 degrees electrical. Therefore, IX will be 693 angle 0 minus 693 at an angle minus 50. That gives us a value of 58.575 angle minus 25. And if we divide by X, we get the current to be 58.575, angle minus 25. Therefore, the input will be VI equals phi, which is 693 times 58.575 cos of minus 25. That gives us 36.789 kilowatt per phase, which is 110.368 kilowatt. Now it is seen from above that as the motor lead is increased from the rotor displacement from 5 degrees to 50 degrees, E falls back in phase considerably. Ix is increased from 6.05 to 58.6. Power factor increase from 2.5 to 25 degrees, so that the power factor changes from 0.0999 lagging to 0.906 lagging. The increase in power is directly proportional to the increase in delta, and the increase in the machine current is much more than the decrease in the power factor. Now, if we look at the power developed by the synchronous machine, E is equal to V minus IAZ or IMZ, and IM is then V minus E minus delta. Z is angle beta. And then we can say that the developed power is E times the conjugate of the current. Now, if again we look at this phasor diagram, now E over ZS times the conjugate of the current is first one that comes along is V, and therefore that angle between E and V over Z is beta minus delta, and then E over Z is cos beta. The output power is normally V over ZS. The first one that comes along is V over Z, that is cos beta, and E is then cos beta plus delta. Now, if R is negligible, then beta becomes 90 degrees, and therefore P developed is E squared XS sine delta, and the output also becomes VE over XS sine delta. Now, if we look at the developed power, which is EV cos beta minus delta minus E squared over ZS cos beta, for maximum developed power, dP d delta is equal to zero, and therefore we get minus EV over sine beta minus delta is equal to zero, and that will happen when beta is equal to delta. Now, if we substitute this back into E in equation one, we get EV over ZS minus E squared ZS over cos beta. Now, cos beta is normally RA over ZS. So if we stick that back, we get E over VZS minus E squared RA over ZS squared. This is for fixed values of E, V, RA, and XS. And this gives the values of power where the machine falls out of step. So if we're solving for E, we get E is equal to ZS over 2RA times V plus or minus the square root of V squared minus 4RA times PD max. Now for fixed values, V, R, and XS, PDM varies with E. So therefore, dPd dE is V over Z minus 2RAE over ZS squared, and that is equal to zero. And if we substitute it, we get E is equal to VZ over 2RA. Now if we substitute it back into equation one, we get it's v squared over 2ra minus v squared over 4ra. That gives us v squared over 4ra. So that will be the maximum developed power for fixed v, r, and x. Now if you look at example two, a three-phase 3300 star-connected synchronous motor has ZS equal to 2 plus J, 18 ohms per phase. If the open circuit value of E is 3800 volts line, compute the maximum total developed mechanical power and the current and power factor at this power. So if we calculate Z, it is 18.11 at an angle of 83.7. So therefore IZ is going to be V minus E angle minus 83.7. That gives us 2822.47 at an angle 50.8. Therefore the current will be IZ divided by X, that is 155.85 angle minus 32.8 amps per phase. Developed maximum power is EV over ZS minus E squared RA of ZS squared. That gives us a value of 201.537 kilowatt per phase. Total is 604.61 kilowatt. Copper loss in this case is 3 times 155.85 squared times R, which is 2. That gives us 145.642 kilowatt. The input, therefore, is the maximum power plus the copper loss. That gives us a total of 750.252 kilowatt. Power factor is the cosine of 32.8, which gives us 0.841. Leading. Now if we look at another example, a 400 volt 50 hertz 6 pole 3 phase star connected synchronous motor with ZS equal to 0.5 plus J4 ohms per phase. On full load the excitation is adjusted so that the machine takes 60 amp at a power factor of 0.866 lagging. Keeping E constant, compute the maximum power output. Excitation, friction, windage, and iron loss is 2 kilowatt. So ZS is 4.03 angle 82.9. IM is 60 angle 30 degrees, and therefore E is V minus IMZS, it's 231 angle 0 minus 60 angle 30 times 4.03 at an angle of 82.9. That gives us a value of 394.08 angle minus 34.4. And therefore the maximum developed power will be EV over ZS minus E squared RA over ZS squared. That gives us 17.8 kilowatt per phase, or 53.422 kilowatt. So the net output will be PD max minus the losses. It's 53.422 minus 2, which gives us 51.423 kilowatt. Now this concludes the chapter 3. Next, we will discuss the salient pole machine.